Hey, look at this. Blood trail.
There's a passage behind this throne.
A secret passage?
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Maltzignir.
Boy. Over here.
Ah, I was wondering about this. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with... whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
That's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a set. Severed head.
This place looked like in better times.
Conan'sgard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The Dwarf blindly trusted in the legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is the result.
Trust is a gamble, like you said. And the Dwarf King lost. Mimir, why do you have Bifrost crystals in your eyes?
A loving gift from the giants. Since I used to do so much traveling between realms, they thought it would be more convenient for me than having a crystal I could lose.
Did it hurt?
No, because I wisely fortified myself with 16 cups of Billow Maiden's ale. Got so inebriated, I tried convincing the giants to put them in my nipples instead. Almost talked them into it too. Can you imagine? Mimir of the Bifrost Teats. those were the days.
Ew.
Okay, I'll stop now.
You boys look right beaming.
We found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
Else we can do for you?
Nah, just glad you guys worked it out.
Ah, Well, I could say the same to you.
Ha!
I guess I was getting a bit full of myself.
Told him what he needed to hear, how's it sounds to me.
Just the same. I'm sorry for how I spoke to you, Sindri. You forgive me?
Already have. Like you said, it all worked out. Now, let us get back to work before I get...
Better not be fighting with your brother again.
Just because he's gotten a little less annoying over the years doesn't mean I ain't got a customer base of my own to keep happy.
Oh yeah? Who's that?
Well, you came back here, didn't you?
Fair point.